I think that the House has done its part with most of the tax package reforms, no? And the rest are with the Senate. But we've also done some heavy lifting in that regard. We passed the first few tax packages, the most recent being the CREATE, which was shepherded in the House by Kong Joey and Senator Pia in the Senate. So we have a few, the passive income, the PIFITA, but I think the heavy lifting has been done, really, in terms of these other tax reform packages are no longer revenue generating, if I'm not mistaken, except for maybe the tax on POGOs, but that's a new one. That's not really part of the original Duterte tax reform package.
Yes, of course, you would know about heavy lifting regarding that. Talking about, though, the first package and the stigma related to that, Senator.
Sorry, you froze for a bit. You stopped at the stigma.
Senator Sunny, is that still there? And do you think that's going to play a role in the elections next year? Considering there were some people who were angry about that, some economists were still angry about that. How does that play into next year?
I don't think so, Warren, because if you look at the 2019 elections, it didn't really play a role. And so even less so in the 2022 elections. And maybe it might even play a positive role because you'll have another tax rollback or another income tax break coming up for next year. No? So. If that is communicated properly, that could work to the advantage of maybe the administration's candidate.
Right. Congressman Joey, let's talk about the CREATE law that was already enacted, like Revenue Regulation 9-2021 that came out this year. And, you know, the business groups were all up in arms over that. The implementation, again, really, there was a problem with that. What do you think about that?
I don't want to going to adversarial. I look at DOF and BIR as partners. We've done already. I think they already agreed to suspend it. Essentially, implement CREATE would be the more dominant law because it is more recent and probably the most rational. So they suspended already 2021. So there are two. There is that other measure on the proprietary schools. The House has already, we are ready to approve in the committee on Wednesday the bill that essentially will not reverse the Supreme Court, but rather to make it very clear to the Supreme Court what is the intent of that particular provision. And with respect to the 12% on VAT on local suppliers, I think definitely the economic logic is not there. And therefore, we will pass the a remedial legislation as well, aside from the suspension by the BIR and the DOF.
Right. So, we are running out of time, gentlemen, but I had so many questions ready for you, including like the anti-terror law and the gray listing of the... Again, implementation of the laws. We all know how our Congress is really active in passing the legislation that our leaders believe we need. However, the implementation, again, a problematic as displayed by the gray listing of with the ETF. What are your expectations, though, considering that this is the final year of the Duterte administration? Are we going to be able to get anything done? As Sherian was reporting earlier, we're looking already ahead at the elections and there are political movements and maneuvers already. Are we going to get anything done in this final year with Hong Joey?
I think we'll do a lot. We have approved the CDC, the Barrel Institute. I think it's a no-brainer for the Senate. I think the MUP, I think the House has already done its part, but we have to go through the plenary. The Foreign Investment Act is in the Senate in the second reading. The Public Services Act is getting a little longer in the Senate, but the retail trade, I think the impasse will be resolved. And the POGO, I think we might have the first law immediately after the SONA. And I expect basically If I were, I think I would say I'd like to see some real thing on agriculture aside from the Cocoa Trust Fund, and more science being put in place, and probably strengthen the reproductive health law, and of course, but much of the framework really for recovery is in place. So I think raising the mobilizing the revenues, the resources for the economic recovery is more important. So I think that is my expectation. So yung iba, basically the Department of DDR, I think there is no appetite in the Senate. The Department of OFW too, it's been passed in the House, and now we're doing the Department of Water. So, but I think the CDC, and I think and the Virology Institute, and I'd like to pick up from Senator Angara, I'll try to file a bill also, decentralizing the genome centers. So I think that's a that's a brilliant idea actually, since this will be not be the last.
Absolutely. Absolutely, Kong. Thank you for that. Senator Sunny?
Yes, I think Congress has a chance to pass a number of economic measures, as mentioned by Congressman Joey. The Retail Trade Liberalization, yung Public Service Act, the Foreign Investment Act are all in fairly advanced stages already. So I think it's reasonable to expect those three, as well as the revenue measures for the POGO industry or the online gaming industry. And maybe if there's additional time, then additional measures could be tackled as well.
All right. Thank you for your time this morning, gentlemen, Senators Sunny Angara and Congressman Joey Salceda, for your views on the SONA later in the day. Hopefully, we can get you for your reactions after the SONA is delivered by the President. Good morning.
Thank you. Good morning.